Hello, everybody, and welcome to Whippy Skycake Plays Star Wars D&D. We have Bob over here.
Hi.
As our Dungeon Master. We got Brick Cheeks over there in the corner. Messing around with Hulk's son. We got Magnus over here being
I'm just here, pretty much.
And you got me, Ryder, talking to you guys.
So yeah, we're going to be doing a D&D session in the universe of Star Wars, more or less. It's going to be sort of our own alternate universe version of it. So we're not going to follow necessarily all the lore. Even though this guy, he knows all of it.
And if me and Andrew appear somewhat, like, dead, it's because we got, like, 2 hours of sleep.
I have zero.
Yeah.
You didn't sleep?
No.
There's
no point in sleeping for 2 hours.
Yeah, honestly, I was thinking about that. Just like, why don't I
school free zone! So they're very tired.
Well, mate.
I'm a bit ill. William's alright.
Yeah,
I think
I'm also a bit ill.
So yeah, we're gonna do this first session.
I am very hungry.
Three.
We're gonna start, and it's gonna be great, and I hope you enjoy and come along with us as we jizz in your mouth. So I'm gonna let these guys introduce their characters, because, fuck. And you have something prepared, actually, of your backstory, so I'm gonna let you go first. And you guys, because you clearly haven't come up with one yet, I assume, you can come up with one now, as he's thinking.
Okay.
Nick looks like a zombie. So.
I am Deslin Van Damme. I am a Mandalorian bounty hunter, and this is my backstory, okay?
Are you related to Jean-Claude Van Damme?
No.
Oh, well, I hate your character.
Boo, this sucks. I want to go home.
The Van Damme clan has been disgraced for thousands of years since the fall of the, Ozna Van Damme to the Jedi Knight Revan. After beating the famed warrior, Revan seized the Van Damme family armor and has been lost to the galaxy since then. This brought dishonor to the clan, causing our numbers to dwindle until only I, Deslin Van Damme, was left. To jumpstart rebuilding, I must find the armor of the clan to regain our honor. The only clue to this location is an old medallion with the clan crest on it that is in display in a museum on Coruscant. As a part of the Mandalorian War display. Now, I ended up a prisoner of Skiga, right?
Whoa, calm down. We don't need words like that.
How do you pronounce it then?
Skigu.
Skigu?
Skigu.
Yeah, there's a big difference, William, between the word you just said and Skigu.
The hut, well, I was tasked with hunting down and finding information on her brother, Mad Dog, but I was caught.
Modog.
I was caught and sent back with a message to fuck off. Due to my failure, I have one more chance with these motherfuckers.
Yeah, I think in post-editing, see, he's working on some pictures of these characters, and I think I'm going to wait to finish the editing until he's got those in some sort of state where I can take a picture of them, put them in. Who wants to go next?
You go, Andrew.
Oh, okay.
You touched me! You sort of harassed me!
Oh.
That was loud.
I was like, shut up!
This is a very terrible setup, but we're gonna try to fix it maybe. I don't
know. We need like a poster. We need a G Fuel poster right here. FaZe Clan, obey monster hats everywhere.
Eat my ass.
We need the Timberlands.
EA, eat my ass.
Challenge everything.
All right, go ahead.
This is already failing.
I'm Tedric Azeric. I'm an Ewok. Tedric. And I'm 53 years old. I'm 53 years old, I'm an old dude, and I'm a shadow caster, so I like dark magic and like fingering people and with ghosts. And I crawled onto a smuggler's ship when I was a kid, and I don't know where I am. I was sort of like stolen by people, and now I'm here, and I want to go see my people, and be a Mexican, go across the border. Yeah.
You want to be freed?
Yes.
Yeah.
I do not believe Mexican is a proper term.
Did
in
you
the
just
Star
racist
Wars
right
universe?
Now?
No.
Are you actually racisming right now?
I am racism.
He got a 20 on racism.
Holy shit.
Yes! Motherfucker.
That's canon. You're like really racist.
I am official clan member now.
You're officially really racist. That's
Let's go to West Virginia.
Yes!
Okay, Nick, your character.
Alright. My character's name is Aces Terran. I'm 19 years old and an assassin slash thief slash assassin again. So the gist of my character essentially is that my character like his family's just been poor throughout their entire lives and living in the inner cities and seeing no way out, I turn to a life of crime as I see that as the only eligible way of getting out of. You just ruined everything for me.
You fucked this up.
You just ruined my entire charisma. I should have something going, man. Okay, yeah. But
you ruined the flow.
Man, yes. Alright. Yeah, but
20 minutes, people, I see, just say.
I see assassinating people and making money that way is the best way of getting out of my lifestyle and helping my family. And I get caught, and that's why I'm with these people now.
So, if you guys want to look it up on the internet, the classes that we base these characters off, yours is a...
Knight.
His is the Assassin's Creed Assassin.
Pretty much, yeah.
Which, he's a Shadow Mage.
I have some...
Shadow Caster, you prick.
Get it right.
No.
Yeah.
No. No, mages cannot exist in the Shadow Realm.
Fuck it out. Welcome to D&D, everybody.
I think you'll find that mages can't exist in the Shadow Realm. Kill yourself, noob. Okay, let's start. Holy shitting balls.
So yeah, our story takes place.
Takes place in my notes.
Okay. Do you guys actually want pieces of paper to like take notes with?
No, I'm good. I have the memory of a.
Because everything you write down is in your character's
Actually, sure, why not?
My hand is really cold.
My dick is large.
Or a pencil or whatever.
20 minutes, guys. A writing.
20 minutes, everyone.
Do you guys want to begin?
Yes.
I mean, that's why I'm here. So yeah.
Let's just.
I fucking hate you guys.
I feel like let's just do a podcast. So.
Good episode one. Good night.
Our story begins. On the planet of Nar Shaddaa, in the outer system, picture tall city buildings, speeders flying by, and sketchy figures galore. You people know, this planet is particularly under the rule of Skigu the Hutt, daughter of the Hutt Overlord,
Bluntu. It's a woman?
Bluntu. Yeah, Skigu's a woman. The Hutt family rules over many of the planets in this system, the important ones especially. Skigu is not only quiet, but persuasive, meaning you shouldn't mess with her, Andrew. She has many people working for her and is the favored replacement when Bluntu eventually dies. You awaken, all of you.
I'm still asleep.
Come on, let's get some acting.
Hi.
That's how I would go.
Hi.
Ah! Okay. Every morning, the little Ewok's like, ah! And then the assassin's like,
hi.
Eyes heavy, head still pounding from the metal pillow permanently flattening the back of your skull. Or at least trying to. You know this as the prison in Skigu's palace.
She has a prison or a palace?
Yep.
She's it a seems pup. Like poor
puts have pallets.
Pallets? I said pallets. Palace.
Palaces.
Fucking illiterate shit.
They have palaces.
More Kenneth, yeah, he's an illiterate shit who's also racist. You're becoming a redneck.
Yes!
he's an Ewok neck.
Let's make some moonshine!
Red walk.
The moon already does shine.
Tegric!
Get the fuck out.
Tegric. That's your name, right?
Yep.
Okay. You have been here for a while.
Yay!
You've gotten used to your cage. Because you're, like, not a human, so they just throw you in a kennel. The treatment isn't terrible, besides the odd guard that calls you a Wookiee baby. Other than that, you haven't had any contact with Skugu. Skigu. Fuck it. This is gonna be an issue.
Skuga.
Skuga. Skigu.
Skiga.
Skuga. Skiga. My Skiga. Since you refused to work for her when you first got here.
Noopa. Noopa.
Other than that, your life's been pretty alright in the cages. You don't have too many issues with the guards or anything? You're kind of content working on your forciness. Forcible.
I'm humping the cage.
Aces! You've not been here as long as Tegric, but this prison has started to feel a bit like home. But you don't like it,
roll
obviously.
For home.
You should be out in the city. Out in the city, underground, stealing and thieving and sneaking around.
Killing people.
Killing people.
Yeah, killing.
Ripping the throats out and eating them. Maybe not eating them. You shouldn't be stuck in the cell waiting for your one holocall.
What's that reference?
like one.
That's the worst analogy I've ever heard.
What?
So fucking terrible.
Yeah.
You should be thieving. But ironically, that's why you're here.
Yep.
But to be fair, you couldn't give up the chance to go into Skigu's palace dressed as a nobleman and steal all of Skigu's... Fuck, I hate that name already. Gold and riches.
He bought the gold. I got it back.
The issue was, your man on the inside was more than just a man on the inside. He worked for Skigu. So
was
you got caught.
Inside of Skigu?
Maybe. I don't know. But technically, up to this point, only he has seen Skigu's face. All of you have communicated through men who, or not necessarily men, people who work under Skigu. She's very important. Yeah, but now you're here, and you're kind of depressed, you know? You want to be out and about, moving around.
Hi, stop that, you fucking weirdo.
Deslin.
Yeah. Hi.
Yeah. You have not been here long at all.
Yeah.
It was only last night, actually, when the guards dragged your unconscious body into the prison, so...
I did things to you. Different cellmate. I know, I was in a kennel. You can't have been in here.
Oh my god, what are they? Fuck!
I was like sideways.
Let me out of
bars of the cage, like, ah!
Okay. We can take turns. And it was actually 2 days ago when you were caught sneaking into Modog's palace, trying to get information for Skigu.
Being told to fuck off.
And when he kind of hit you on the back of the head, maybe not him specifically, a guard, and he decided to ship you back to Skigu in a sewage disposal ship. So pretty much...
I smell like shit.
You were in shit for a few days. But now you're here, because Skigu got pissed off that you got
told
caught.
Yeah,
and while you don't really know what information you got from Modog, but you know you got some, but she was disappointed with how they figured out you were there. Anyway, as you awaken, you begin to realize the reason you were suddenly awoke, you were suddenly jolted awake by the feeling of a shock on your neck, and you two know that when you're in this prison, you get a shock collar.
I'm so hard.
And if you do anything that makes the cards angry or makes Skigu angry or anyone under her, they're gonna kill you. But they do use it to keep you in good shape in terms of when you go to bed, when you wake up, when you eat, that sort of thing. You have no idea why this thing's around your neck. You just woken up and all of a sudden you're like, is this, they must be kind of kinky in this place, I don't know, it's kind of weird. Does this like double as a ball gag? You don't know. Yeah, so you've never seen this in your life. But you do remember today was the day. Sorry to drop bad news on you guys, but like, you may or may not be executed today.
Yes.
You don't know. You know some people are going, but you don't know who it is.
Do I know this?
I need some sleep.
No, you don't know.
Okay.
I'll go. Kill me!
I volunteer as tribute!
So yeah, you awaken and you can see a prison. You're in a prison, obviously. Aces, you are in a prison closest to the door, out of the three of you. In the prison across from you, you can see some sort of battle droid that, for some reason, they decided not to disable. They just threw him in prison. Like, it's a droid. They're dumb
what
as hell.
What type of battle droid?
Do I speak common, by the way?
Any sort of... Yeah, you all do.
Good.
Any sort of, you know, assassin-y... You know the ones that follow General Grievous? It kind of looks like that.
Okay.
They're, like, a bit hooded, but they've got, like, robotic features.
It's just HK-47.
He has an AK-47, though. You...
Hello, meatbag.
I didn't know your name, so I literally just wrote Ewok in here. But, Tegric, you're in the prison next to, Aces.
The kennel.
But not across from. So imagine there's a...
Didn't you draw a map?
Door, Aces, meat.
Not for this bit, because there's no combat at this point, so...
Okay.
Unless you piss someone off, of course.
Door,
but,
Aces, meat.
But at this point, imagine a large room, and there's three cells on either side... And there's a carpet going down the middle.
Ooh,
you two are next to each other on one side, and you can see across. Across from you is an empty cell with nothing but blood in it. So, and the door is wide open.
I want to go in.
You
can't.
I'm not at the door.
Kennel, you.
I'm not at the door of my kennel.
Next to you again is a creature that you know as Macer. It's pretty much a giant pig creature that could probably strangle you in your sleep if he got loose. And across from Macer, you see a new prisoner.
Sup?
Deslin.
Sup?
You're a Mandalorian. So you look like a human.
Yeah.
And yeah, that's the room. I don't know if you guys want to do anything. The battle droid seems to be shut down, so you don't really know why he's in a...
Is it possible for Macer to break out of his prison cage?
You could ask him.
Macer, can you break out?
He seems very angry.
Uh-huh.
It doesn't seem like there's much coming from that side. Uh-huh. And he's like feasting on like a massive leg of some creature. Mm. He's going...
Are there any guards in the prison?
The door nearest to Ace's, you can see like arms sort of like this on either side of the door.
Is there anything in my cell besides me?
In your cell, you have a metal bed with no blankets or pillows, just like a sheet of metal. And you have a hole for pissing and pooing into. That's about it.
Can I fit in the hole?
Do you want to try?
Not really.
Okay.
Because
you know that those things don't flush.
Oh God.
I mean.
But technically, you just came in, so you haven't used it yet. This is the first time you've been conscious in your cell, so.
I'm just gonna take a shit, man.
Okay.
All right. That's what on impulse.
That's what he's dropped his pants and he's. And I will remind you at this point, you guys have no gear on you. You pretty much just have the basic prison clothes. You're assuming that they took your stuff whenever you were brought in, and you know they took your stuff a long time ago. You've been here a long time. And you know,
I get the gist of it.
You sort of got the idea that.
Fuck you, leave me alone, man.
So, you guys want to do anything?
I get naked and I defecate in my
house. At this point, you don't really know what's happening. You assume that some sort of food is coming, but you have time to talk.
Get naked, defecate.
And you've never seen this guy.
Get naked, defecate in my hand, and okay. I watch William.
Okay.
Kill myself. Can I do that? Can I do that technically?
If you wanted to.
Go home.
No.
Technically, people would have a chance to be able to save you.
Who?
If a guard saw you, they could technically come and save you if they wanted to.
So I'm taking a shit. He's naked and taking a shit.
Yeah.
And you're
next suicide.
Make me a constitution saving throw. You're pooping into your hand, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Give me a constitution throw. Anyway. Just a
roll. Why are you pooping in your hand? You have a toilet.
Because I'm an Ewok. I defecate
into
my hand.
Yeah. And you throw it, right? At people.
15. 15 plus or whatever.
One.
So
16.
Yeah, no, you've done this before, you know what you're doing.
Yeah.
You don't feel sick in any way. You're like, yeah, I'm confident in my hand pooping abilities. You wanna be doing anything?
can
you
wanna
question this strange man at all or
can I just look around my surroundings if I haven't done that before?
Perception check.
Perception,
yeah. Give me a perception check. That would be I'm pretty sure it's a wisdom.
Yeah.
We have perception in here, don't we?
No, we took that out.
Wisdom.
13.
Plus.
No, it was 13.
Yeah, but you had it on 11.
I did.
Yeah, wisdom.
Plus 3,
yep.
Oh. So,
16.
Really what you notice is it seems like the guards at the door are talking to other guards. Like, people have come up and started to speak, like, we need to get in here type of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Other than that, you have the normal cell that you've always had. I would say you probably have tried to, like, hide things on your person from time to time, being a stealthy person, and you probably have some sort of, like,
you have
shiv,
a knife in your anal cavity.
Like, you have a shiv, like,
terrible.
Strapped around your, like, thigh or something like that.
Why didn't I search him?
Well, it's probably, like, he's gone out to do stuff, he's probably come back in and with stuff. Or,
yeah.
And he's very sneaky, he could probably do something.
No, I stole a knife from the kitchen.
Yeah.
From the cafeteria, and I've been sharpening it ever since.
So he's got it on him. Other than that, you guys want to do anything else? You want to question anyone?
Could I try opening the door with a lock check? See if they forgot to lock my door?
Sure.
Uh-huh.
I would say you have to go. Yeah, no. You're trying, you're like, and I would say the guards kind of like look over and see you like bang on the door. Obviously they've seen prisoners do that, so they're not too bothered, but they're kind of like, their conscience, They're conscious of you trying to get out.
Hey, guys, my door's unlocked.
Hey, everybody, just open the door.
Yeah, and just like, I've never tried that.
You're still in there.
Yeah, I'm still in
there. I get up sideways on the bars of the door and I try gnawing at the door.
Strength?
While still holding poop in my hands.
Is that a strength or dexterity?
I would say, because you've been here so long, it doesn't work. Like, you would have tried this before. Yeah. Do you want
to,
like, use...
I'm not trying to get out, I just like biting
the door. Okay, yeah, then you don't need to roll anything.
He's just gnawing.
I was, like, biting the door.
I just want to ask one more time, you don't want to ask anyone anything, you're comfortable just doing your normal routine?
Yeah, I mean...
I would say for the most part, this is the first time in, like, years that you've seen someone be brought into this cell.
I mean, like, I'm insane.
Do you guys know
what
I'm in?
The guy next to me wants to kill me. He's pooping.
No, I'm done pooping.
Yeah.
I'm done pooping.
It seemed like, compared to your shits, it was a pretty average, like, human shit. Like, he just needed to go and get done with.
I didn't yo-yo for 5 hours.
Yeah.
You yo-yoed the
shit.
Why do
you think my anal cavity is closed?
You used floss.
I asked them if they know why I'm in here.
Them?
Yeah.
I fling my poo out the door.
Do you guys want to make, I'd say if you make a wisdom check, you could see if you know anything.
Okay. Can I just ignore him?
Yeah, if you want to, yeah.
Yeah.
You
can give us a wisdom check, this
what?
One.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
D20. I'd say I'm going to pull these out while we're not using them.
If I'm an assassin, I'm not very trusting to people.
Yeah, I'd say that's good roleplay. A lot of times what you want to ask yourself is not necessarily what would you do, but what would 21. Your character do?
21!
Yeah, you've definitely, from all the times you've been in here and the listening, you've like, you know that something went on with a mission, and you remember, sort of in your sleep last night, you remember hearing someone being dragged in.
You were dragged in, and your mission failed.
Oh, shit.
You smell like shit.
Oh, you're doing fun mine on you.
Hey,
bit of a hypocrite if you
do. Do we ever get
like
shower
shit.
Time?
Yeah, I don't use it, but yeah.
When is it? When is it? I smell like shit over here.
Like after lunch or dinner?
Oh, shit. When's lunch?
You know, like.
Is a shower
lunchtime.
After lunch?
Yeah, but what time is it?
I'm prison.
Oh, boy.
How
classic
long have I been
lunch.
Unconscious?
How am I supposed to know? I'm insane.
How long have I been unconscious?
What is time?
Okay, he doesn't know.
Okay, as you're having this conversation, two of the guards walk in, one and one comes in from behind
Billy!
Both of them. And one walks up to each of your cell, including Macer, and Macer begins to open the cell and pretty much says, "Come quietly or we'll fuck you up, bitch." Pretty much, like...
Should I try to choke? No, okay, I'll go quiet.
Try to choke?
As you say that, though... you just think it.
I'm thinking that.
Yeah. Macer, as soon as the cell's open, he charges the guard, but as he's about to, like, ram into the guard, his collar explodes. his head literally, like, comes off of his body, and he just falls. Like, the force rams into the guard, obviously, because it's, like, momentum and stuff, but...
Shit!
He's dead. He's, like...
That bitch dead.
This was, like, one of the strongest creatures you've ever seen. He's just been killed in a second.
I start humping the door.
He did.
And as for the robot, he's not, like, the guards don't give a shit. For some reason, I don't know, it was writer's block when I put him in. Do you want to try to stop, or do you want to just go with the guards?
How many people are in
oh,
my
wait,
cell?
We have the shock.
Guard?
I'm not...
How many people in general?
In my cell.
I asked my guard if I could go take a shower.
He says, shut the fuck up.
is there just one guard or two guards?
I would say there's a guard in your cell with you and there's a guard outside your cell.
Who's watching me?
Yeah.
Okay, then I'll just go with them.
Okay. So the guards cuff you and you begin to be led out of the prison.
Am I going or like...
Yeah.
Did you want to fight back?
No.
Okay.
I was humping the door.
And this is pretty weird because like, how long have you been in this prison?
Yeah.
Would you say... Hmm? How long have you been in this
How
prison?
How old are you? You're
say?
53. You've
I
been here
hear...
for 50 years.
Yeah, I was
yeah,
like,
at
I
age
was like
three,
two,
yeah.
So like 51.
So I'd say, in terms of being led somewhere by guards, this is probably the first time this has happened since you got here. So.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a long time.
You've pretty much been forgotten about, pretty much. But yeah, I guess.
Crazy old guy.
Crazy fucking Ewok.
One of them calls you Wookiee Baby. And you walk through the halls, the long dark halls of the palace. It feels like you're walking for a long time. Like, maybe, it feels like hours. It probably isn't, but it feels that way. Just from how samey the hallways are. As you just continually turn corners and seem like you're advancing, maybe, through the bright lit tunnels. Then, as you turn your final corner, still bound, the main officer who wasn't holding any of you guys, you've probably got like two officers carrying you along, but there's one who's just walking on his own. He walks up to a keypad next to a door and enters a code, and the door opens. Would you guys like to do anything at this point? Say anything or try to get out of your minds?
I'll just wait.
Can I do like a wisdom check to see, or a luck, or some check that to see if I could see what the code was for the
keypad? I would say perception check.
Perception,
which
so
is wisdom.
Nah. Nope, I got a 2. Didn't happen.
Actually, it would be intelligence.
Intelligence, okay.
For our investigation. Well, 10. Keep the original roll. So.
Okay, 2. So two. Still nothing
two
happened.
2 plus whatever. I would say,
they punched me in the face.
You hurt yourself.
So are you trying to do this stealthily, like, without anyone noticing? Like,
yeah.
Make a...
Dexterity.
I would say make a deception check, so that's charisma. You're trying to deceive them into thinking you're not looking.
Would I get the plus 2 for it being, like, underworld people from the...
Nah, this is just some guard. Probably doesn't even know who you are. Yeah, he notices. And as he's done typing in the code, he sort of comes up to you, hits you right in the gut, because he can tell you're looking. And I would say... Take 1 damage.
Could I actually do the same thing that William did?
Try to see the code?
Yeah,
I need.
Yeah, I would say make a investigation check.
Okay. Which is intelligence, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you guys want me to go get an actual eraser, or are you guys good?
I'm fine.
Okay.
I got 12 plus 1.
I would see what you can tell is that the code he entered, it wasn't really numbers. It was sort of like the classic Star Wars symbols. Mm-hmm. And I'd say... You were able to get down the code, like, you sort of understand. I can't, like, say what it is, because it's, like, gibberish, pretty much, but you know the symbols that he pressed in. So if you were ever need to open that door, you could do it.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
Okay, you know, just, but I'm getting really bad rolls, except for the one for Andrew's racism.
Yes. Yeah. The only thing you roll well, Andrew's racism. So you guys, that's all you guys want to do?
Yeah.
I fling poo in his face.
You already flung the poo at me.
Your hands are bound.
You can Candy still go like, eh.
You don't have any poo left. You already flung it at me.
Well, it was on the floor.
You flew
poo? I'm pretty sure the guards would have cleaned his hand when they handcuffed him.
Do you want to try to stealth the poo in?
Sure.
Shove it back up the anus.
So roll me a deception, which is charisma.
Oh boy.
For
charisma,
for
I have plus 2. 4, 6.
Okay, yeah, they you don't have the poo anymore. They smacked that out of you a long time ago. But yeah, as he finishes entering the code, the door opens.
So the door closes.
And you see a room with sort of a blue tint, but you assume it's some sort of light in the room. And they push you in, no guards with you. Closes.
Okay.
Do you guys want to make a... I would say make a perception check, each of you. To see sort of like...
14.
See if you notice sort of what kind of room it is.
Wisdom?
That's all, guys. Thanks for watching. Keep on geeking on.
Keep on geeking on.
Have fun. Nice
exploded. Don't sting in my goal.
Yeah.
Smuck some wed.
Oh, yeah.
That was the outros.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you can keep
I'll move this to here for now.
Just drop it.